Good morning. I'm out in Zone 8 at Chalfont and Latimer by the no more in use disused bay platform. It was last used in 2010 when trains used to shuttle between here and where I'm going to the end of the line today at Chesham. And this video is sponsored by Surfshark VPN. More on them in a moment. Chesham is on a 3.89 mile long single track branch that heads north shortly after leaving Chalfont and Latimer. It's the furthest station away from central London, 25 miles, and was actually here in 1889, 3 years before Amersham was built, as the Metropolitan Railway had plans to head north and meet with the railway at Tring, but that never happened. And a brilliant fact about Chesham is that departing trains have no starting signal, because once the train has entered the branch at Chalfont, nothing else can come onto the line, meaning that the train has the track all to itself. And the driver just uses a clock on the platform to know when to depart as per the scheduled time in the timetable. Welcome to the top left, the north and the west, the most northerly and the most westerly point is Chesham Station. Here is that clock that I talked about, which is how the driver knows when to depart. Let's get some more common facts out of the way first, and then we'll dig deep and see what we can find. Here's the old platform one, which is no longer used. The tracks were removed a long time ago, and at the end by where the buffers have been turned into a garden. A winning garden, no less, in the 1993 London Underground Gardens competition. There's two Grade 2 listed structures here, just to really make Chesham feel like it's super quaint, and should still be seeing steam trains and not electric ones. With this, the original water tower, which is super impressive, and on the far side, where the other platforms used to be and the track down to the goods yard, there's this original wooden signal box, no longer in use sadly. Oh, and you'll note with interest that its labyrinth artwork is number one in the series of 270, and I'm going to explain what these are all about in a future episode. And you can sort of enter the base of the water tower now, because it's been turned into this bike storage facility. If you're travelling from Chesham, come right and lock your bike here.
Up by the buffers at the end of the platform, I'm trying to work out if there's a way round to the signal box.
I'm gathering that the signal box maybe does have open days, or there are times when you can access it because it goes down here along some steps, along a path, and you get to it. I'd love to know how you get access to the signal box at Chesham. Just found something very cool. I think there's only a couple of these left on the system now. Chesham has one of them, this yellow metallic bin. The blue sticker there, the giveaway, used tickets from the days of paper tickets before the barrier gates came in. You could deposit your ticket here at the end of your journey. Really nice to see.
So, things to do in Chesham then. Well, as the sign literally says, walkers are welcome. And in the Chilterns here, there's loads of places where you can indeed go for a beautiful scenic walk. I found this nearby Jacob's Ladder set of steps, which leads up to a path, and then this footbridge with great views down onto the railway. But when the trains aren't rumbling past by, it's very quiet and very peaceful here. All I could hear were the birds and the occasional plane in the sky.
You know, because we're in the depths of Zone 9, and it feels like the least undergroundy underground station on the whole network, it's like we're in another world. And talking of being in another world, that reminds me of today's sponsor.
So Surfshark VPN is an app and browser extension that encrypts your internet data and lets you safely browse the web using over 3,000 servers in over 95 countries around the world. And you can browse the internet as if you are using it in another country, in another part of the world. This means you can use streaming services, use discounts, and go online shopping in places that might not normally be available in your country. For example, Surfshark lets people in the UK watch American Netflix and vice versa. And it's got the bonus of keeping your IP address hidden, which means it keeps your data safe and private, so you can switch it on when you don't want to be tracked by advertisers or trackers. And you can subscribe with just one account, and with that, you can use Surfshark on all your devices, computers, phones, and tablets. Which is why you should click on the link in the description below and use the code Geoff, G-E-O-F-F, to get a whopping 83% discount off Surfshark, which includes an extra 3 months for free. So transport yourself around the world, far beyond even Zone 9, by using Surfshark VPN. Chesham Station building is lovely. Inside, in the ticketing area, it's so lovely in fact that the place where there's a rack with tube maps also has leaflets for local things to do. And just when you thought it wasn't quaint enough, I found this, an old wooden suggestion box. I definitely can't think of any other tube stations that has one of those. Shame. But has it got the most important of station amenities?
Yeah, and if you're playing along with the bingo sheet, and why wouldn't you be, then you'll be thrilled and excited as I am to know that Chesham does indeed have a car park. It's just a car park. The interesting fact about Chesham's car park, though, is that this used to be where the goods yard was right up until, well, back in the days of steam, 1960s, I think. Goods yard, right here. It's now a car park. Tick that one off.
Chesham's got a really nice town centre. This is the high street, plenty of independent shops, some chains but not too many. There's an impressive clock tower too, and they have a market here twice a week. It's not the first time I've been here though.
The story that I always like to tell people is that what got me into the tube and the underground was, as a small child, my older cousins took me on a ride on the central line from Epping to Ongar, and that kind of introduced me to the concept of like extremities of the tube map. And it was in 1988, I was 14, with my friend out for the day, teenagers hanging out in London, we had our paper travel cards, and I remember turning to my friend and saying, I wonder what's in the extremity in the northwest corner, let's just randomly go to Chesham. And so we did, we got the Metropolitan line, A stock trains, high back seats, all the way out to here. And all I remember is that there was a newsagent just over there, and I went in and I got myself like a can of drink and a pack of crisps, and we sat in the high street and we drank our drink and ate our crisps and then got the train back. On the way back in, the London Underground member of staff went, your paper travel cards aren't valid out this far, but he let us in anyway. So yeah, 1988 is when I first came to Chesham.
That's it, thanks.
I'm trying to pretend like it's 1988 again, whilst also trying not to think about the fact that that was over 30 years ago.
So instead, I thought about something else, and my mind returned to that suggestion box.
And I'm so enamoured by the suggestion box, I've just been to the shop and bought myself a notepad and pen, and I'm going to leave a suggestion that actually says, dear TFL, please have more suggestion boxes at other stations. Thanks, Jeff.
I then spoke to a member of staff who suggested that I checked out the waiting room.
Okay, the waiting room is fabulous. One, there's a heater in here, so it's warm on a cold January day. Secondly, it's got the station garden competitions winning certificates from all the years, all throughout the 90s. There's loads, along with a whole bunch of black and white photos and stuff showing you how Chesham Station used to look. So when you come to Chesham, because you have to come to Chesham, spend 5 minutes checking out all the old photos and everything that's in the waiting room.
Just time for one quick admirational glance at the hanging baskets on the platforms, and then it was time to get the train back home.
So that is Chesham Station, episode 10 of this End of the Line series. My thanks to Surfshark for sponsoring this video. Their details and links are in the description below. Please also press subscribe to my channel and check out the playlist with all the other episodes in this series so far. See you soon. Thanks, bye.